Now that we've set up our development environment, let's move on to building our Django application. So let's start by creating what's called a virtual environment on our development server. So I'm gonna load up the git bash and I'm gonna change to the location of our profiles REST API project. So that's cd workspace profiles REST API. If you don't already have the Vagrant service up and running, then type Vagrant up to start the Vagrant server. This will take a few seconds because I don't currently have it running on my machine. So it needs to boot the operating system and load it so that we can connect to the Vagrant box and continue on with the steps. While that's loading, I'm going to load up Atom and I'm going to make sure I have the profiles REST API project loaded in the Atom Explorer here. Here you go. So I have Atom open. I have the profiles project, the profiles REST API project. I'm just going to close all of these tabs off. So once our service is up and running, we're going to start by creating what's called a virtual environment. Now, a virtual environment is a virtual wrapper which you can use to install Python applications. So our Python app that we're going to build is going to have various dependencies. So it's going to use various other Python packages. So I mentioned earlier on in the course that we're going to be using something called Django. It's a Python web framework. And we're also going to be using something called the Django REST framework. So we're going to install these as Python packages. So both of these frameworks are available to install as Python packages. So we want to install these requirements on our system so that we can use them when we're building our app. Now, you can just install them directly on the system. The problem with that is if you want to run multiple apps on one server or multiple projects on one server, then sometimes these requirements can conflict. So the best practice is to use what's called a virtual environment to separate the different sets of requirements or Python packages for each project that you run on the server. That way you can have as many different applications running on your Linux server as you like, and you can separate all of the requirements. So the versions aren't going to conflict and they're going to be separate from each other. Okay, so now that our Vagrant box is loaded up, let's type Vagrant SSH to connect to it. All right, so now that we're connected to it, we're going to use what's called the virtualenvwrapper. That was a tool that I mentioned we installed earlier on, and it's actually defined here in our Vagrant file. So we install it and configure it here, this virtualenvwrapper. So we're going to use this to create a virtual environment for our project. So when you create a virtual environment, you simply write mk virtualenv. This is stands for make virtual environment. Mk virtualenv, and then the name of the environment we want to create. So it's always a good idea to give the name of the environment the same name or a similar name as the project or app that we're going to be building. So I'm going to call our virtual environment the profiles API environment. Okay, so this would create a virtual environment, but we want to make sure that we're creating a virtual environment that's based on Python 3. So by default, on Linux Ubuntu servers, when you currently to date, so the Ubuntu Xenial operating system that we installed as our base image for our Vagrant box, that uses Python 2 by default. And that's because they're still in the process of transitioning from Python 2 to Python 3. But Python 3 is the latest version, and it's the recommended version for building all new applications. Unless you have some specific requirement that you need to use Python 2 for, then I always recommend using Python 3, because then you're up to date and you're using the latest version and you've got the latest features of Python. So we need to apply a switch here called Python equals Python 3. So you type mk virtualenv space, the name of the environment we want to create, and another space, then two dashes, and then Python. So that's telling it which version of Python we want to use, equals Python 3. So that's the command. So hit enter there, And it's going to go and it's going to create a virtual environment with the name that we provided. Okay, so now that that's done, you can see that at the beginning of our bash command line here, it's added this profiles API. That means we're currently working on the profiles API virtual environment. So any Python packages we install while we have this prefix here on our bash command line is going to install them into the virtual environment that we're currently working on. So if you need to switch or close the virtual environment, then what you do is you type deactivate and hit enter. So after you type deactivate, you can see that the profiles API prefix has disappeared. So now we're just on the base operating system, on the root operating system of our development server. If we want to switch back to our virtual environment, we use the work on command. So to switch back to the virtual environment, you simply type work on, then the name of the environment you want to work on. Hit enter, and you can see that the profiles API prefix comes back. Okay, so that's how you create and use a virtual environment on a Linux server. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.